Hello, YouTube modeling community. This is Rusty Roeder with a What's on My Bench. Just a big mess. We have gotten the Budweiser build. We're ready for final assembly. Things just got to dry first, real good. Few little decals left to put on it. And then that part of it will be done. And then it'll be moving on to the ramp truck. The Caliente, the 1964 Mercury Comet, is done. We'll take a look at it here in a second. Remember, this is going to be the second place prize. Had a lot of people reach out to me and said that, you know, it'd be really cool to give away a build. You know, I've explained before, it's hard for me to give my builds away or sell them or anything like that. I would sell off my kits before I sold off my built models. It's just because, you know, you get so much work put into it, and it's priceless to you, so it's kind of hard to give them away. I know there's a lot of people that have no problem with just building one and giving it away. They don't, you know, hold anything like that, but I do. So, but this one, I knew since it was a curbside, it didn't have a buttload of detail in it. It had just the right amount to make it a neat resto mod. Kind of like the storyline in process, you know. The guy got the paint job done, got all the trim done on the car redone, got the interior redone, had all the suspension done. He, you know, he bought his tires and wheels and got those on. And the engine is the last thing to be done. And that's the guidelines that we built this under. So we got a great paint job. It's not perfect, but it's one of my better paint jobs. It could have been better, but overall it turned out really nice. The stance turned out perfect, exactly how I wanted it to be. Beautiful color choice. I love this pepper gray. We'll take a look at the underneath of it first. You can see we just did some detail painting and some weathering. Nothing spectacular. We didn't have to modify other than drill some new holes to drop the front end down a little lower. But everything is right out of the kit. Tires and wheels excluded because they are aftermarket. That's the only aftermarket piece on it. It's the tires and wheels. And they turned out really nice. It does have the brake and rotor detail. If you look in there, you can see. So all four wheels have the brakes and rotors. You know, so this kid, that's where all his money went. It was updating the brake system, the suspension, tires and wheels, the paint job, restoring all the chrome trim and the bumpers and, you know, all that. The only thing he's got left is the engine, and, you know, he's going to do that little by little. You know, eventually he'll want to put a Coyote in it and, you know, new exhaust and all that. But right now he's just running the six-cylinder. It's a nice weekend cruiser. Be a daily driver with that six-cylinder in there. Take a look at the front end. Not a lot of detail. The front end is kind of wonky to me as far as the looks of it. Looks like a Lincoln almost. It's got that real crisp line on the fenders and the way it comes in. It reminds me of a Lincoln Continental in the front, just smaller. Tail end looks really good. We got my signature tag on there. Everything black washed. We hand painted all the emblems instead of using the decals. I should have shaved these off when I was doing the body work. I didn't think about it, and the decals didn't want to conform over top of them, so we opted out and I hand painted those along with the letters on the sides of the quarters. Everything else is bare metal foil, and I hate bare metal foil. This wasn't too awful bad to do though after I got into it. Even the little markers up here, trim, those are bare metal foil. We detailed in here a little bit. We were going to add seat belts. I opted out of that because the 64 didn't have seat belts. The body will come off the chassis. I didn't glue it together. The interior tub is glued to the body, but where I glued it, you can pop it off pretty easy if you want to get in there and add the seat belt detail. I will include the ribbon, not the hardware, so you can put seat belts in it if you want to. And finish out the story. whoever wins this, if you want to finish out the story, I want to see pictures of your progress doing it, adding the seat belts, converting it over to where the hood opens and it's got, a full engine detail in it. Mind you, if you do that and you mar the paint up a little bit, this would be easily to be stripped. I mean, you have to redo the bare metal foil and the red on the side and all that. But if you want to go into that big of a build or take over from that part, remember it's MCW pepper gray paint. You can get that at Hobby Nut Models if you have to go back through and repaint the car. But me, if I was to win this, it would just go in a display case and set up on a shelf or in my office somewhere and, admire it for what it is. It's a nice clean build. We struggled a little bit on a few things, but we worked through them and it came out pretty nice. My inspiration pictures is how I built it. I know guys that buy built models all the time and they tear them apart and turn them into something fantastic. I really wouldn't want to see that with this. I mean, if you want to go on the storyline and add an engine and the drive line and all that, that'd be cool to see. But again, if it was me, I would just put it in a display case and admire it for what it is. There's that. But it did turn out really nice. We got the shifter in there. And after I glued the shifter in, I broke the little handle off somehow again. Part of it's there, but we did get all the decals on the dash. That turned out really nice, highly detailed. If you look at it the right way, you can see in there and see all that detail. Glass went in perfect. Didn't have any problems with the glass. All the chrome fit perfect. Bumpers, no fitment issues whatsoever on any of this. So I recommend this kit highly. Go get it. It's an easy build. And it has a lot of possibilities to be turned into something. It is a very small car. You got to keep in mind, back in 64, this wasn't a big car. This was a small car. But it was a, financially feasible car for families to buy, And I don't recall ever seeing one of these in real life. If I do, I don't remember it. But, we got a nice, look at those wide tires in the back. This fit without any modification. Fit right in there. Front tires, we did raise the holes up a little bit to get that front end to drop. Same way, they fit in there, no problem. Rotor details in there. They're not glued. So the caliper was down, that's why I was turning it. Turn this one, get it where it needs to be. There we go. All right, now they're set right. It's a really clean build. So I hope whoever wins it treasures it, enjoys, looking at it. It's a great prize. And normally this would be like a first place prize. This is just second place. So if that gives you any indication on how big this giveaway is. So we're kind of combining two of them into one, the 500 mark and the 1,000 sub mark, all into one. From here on out, they won't be that big, but they'll still be a good giveaway from time to time. When we get in that 850, 860, we'll announce third place. We'll show you what it is. And when we get up in the 900s, we'll start showing you everything for first place. What else? Oh, health-wise, back's getting worse. From day to day, I'll have it in my back and a little bit down my leg. Most of the time, I just want to hack my leg off, my hip and my leg. That's where all the pain is. And the leg is starting to get weak now. I can't walk on it very much at all. Just going from the living room to the bathroom it hurts so bad that I can't even describe the pain level. Sitting still is really comfortable, I guess I could say, but I can't just sit there either. So it's a combination of everything, lack of sleep, boredom, pain, it's driving me insane. We do have a bug running around the house, Daughter's sick, granddaughter's sick. Wife thought she was getting it, but she's not for sure yet. I've not got it. It was vomiting and diarrhea, so I don't care to have any of that, especially with this back the way it is. If I'm straining to cough or, yak, oh boy, I think I'll have to sleep in the bathroom. We are on the edge of New Year's, so I hope everybody's safe and parties safely and smart this weekend. New Year's resolutions. I hope to build more models, cleaner, better, finish something that I start, take better care of myself, and be more productive in the community. That's what the shop was designed about, was to be able to bring other people in here, let them sit down at my shop, have a space to work at, all the tools at their, within their reach or their grabs, and get somebody, interested into the hobby, whether it be a family member or just, a stranger. So we're hoping for that. We do have a kit coming, completely outside of my wheelhouse, which I like as a challenge for me. I think you're going to enjoy it. Well, I guess we'll leave it as a surprise. It's a kit that I've looked at probably 30, 40 times, and thought, well, this isn't a car or a truck. I would like to build this. For some reason, just this one kit has drawn me to it. And I finally pulled the gun. I talked to Mark. I said, hey, if it's feasible or possible, I would like to do a open box review on this kit and a build on it. I think it'd be good to bring some different dynamics to the channel, something totally different, and bring you guys along for it. So I hope you like, what's about to come and what's happening. It's not going to be an everyday thing, but it's something new, and it's something that's, it's like looking at a certain car, it draws you to it. You got all these ideas for it, and then you have the chance to get it, and you're like, eh. Then you look at something else. It's kind of the way this is, even though it's not in my realm of things I normally do, but I'm looking forward to it for some reason. It draws me in, and I think once I start building it, it's going to take like all my concentration on it, and that's what I'm looking for. Because I go in 500 different directions all the time, and it does hamper me more than help me. So with this, if I can focus my attention on this and start it and finish it, that'll help me regroup and work on, all these other projects we got going on. Got dry throat today for some reason, but I'm gonna turn it around. You guys can see all the NASCAR stuff. Everything else, everything's ready. Everything's been detail painted. It's just ready for final assembly. And you can see this workspace is an absolute mess, as it is all the way down, just piled up and piled up. And then this space over here is just all piled up and piled up. We did get the glass in. Get all the trim painted. This is 100% done, other than adding the adjusters where they go, and we're just waiting on those to dry. And then, like I said, everything down here is ready to go. So we'll have this wrapped up in the next couple of days, and then hopefully when the new project gets here, we'll kick off starting on it, along with, hopefully, since I can get this injection, hopefully that first injection helps. That I can stand up and we can start getting this desk area done and start organizing the room, because right now it looks like somebody set a bomb off in here and this is where everything landed type thing. I don't even know where half the stuff is myself, and usually I'm organized enough that I know where it is, and right now I don't. That's pretty much it. Thank you to all my past and present subs. Future subs, you guys watching this video, you want to see what's going on in my twisted world of modeling, you know, hit that bell notification, drop me a sub. When the giveaway comes, that's really the only qualifications. You got to be subbed to my channel, and not sub for a day and then unsub afterwards. You got to be subbed for a while. So get in there and, you know, get those subs in. Tell everybody you know, like, it's free. Just cost you a little time out of the day to watch a video. And there's nothing better than that. You know, a little time gap there. Sit down, watch a video. You may be interested in what I'm doing. It may inspire you, which is my number one goal. Hopefully it inspires other people. I got to give a big shout out to William at Ruckus Rods and Customs. Try saying that real fast 5 times. Mr. William, I watched your video. I'm floored. Thank you. I will cherish it to my bitter end. He built the Cadillac Eldorado as his replica for the group build, and he is sending it to me. So when we get it, we'll look over it, and we'll do a video on it with the Deora. And we're just waiting on a few people. They've already contacted me, so I know what's going on. But soon as they get all the pictures to me, I can get that collage picture made and get that out to you as a thank you for participating. Again, next year it'll be, you know, was it October, November? Yeah. It'll start October 27th to all the way through December 27th. That gives you 3 months. Or is it September? September, all September, October, November, December. We may throw that in there from September. I can't remember where we started at. It's been so long. But primarily have 3 months to do the build. And next year we'll be a little more organized. I'm going to have a printed copy that I can send to you via the mail of the list of cars you can pick and the rules. That way you have them in your hand and you'll know what you can and cannot do. And we're going to add a little more selection of Hot Wheels. This still, the key thing is it's got to have the red line tires and wheels. It does require you have to spend a little money, but you know, at the end of the day, you get a great build out of it and a lot of fun. And I will be able to print those tires and wheels from this time going forth. I've not got the file yet, but it's just a matter of going on and getting the file. And you know, you can still get them through Ryan also, so it'll be a couple channels to be able to get the wheels from here on out. So yeah, once we get them together, I'll post on one of the videos a picture of each and everybody's build as like a whatever you call it. At the end of a video, you'll get to see each and everybody's builds, including mine. Let's see, what else? Yeah, but four of us are completely done. Me, William, Craig, and can't remember the other gentleman's name. Four of us are done, and they submitted their pictures. William still got to submit his pictures via my email. But the other three, one's a husband and wife duo, and then Marcy. I know she had some issues and with the kit and, you know, other things going on, but they've contacted me. I know that they're going to be submitting them here soon, so I'm looking forward to that. And then I don't know what group builds I'll get in on this year. I don't know what. Kind of lost right now for what's going on, what started to kind of jump into. So we'll see as the year goes. Maybe a small scale group build. I will get involved in the Pro Street from Dillon NYS modeling this year. I don't know what I'm going to build yet. I'm still kind of fumbling around some ideas. I kind of want to do something different than everybody else. So There's a good possibility of something that I want to do and make it a Pro Street. So we'll see how that pans out. What else? Oh, 3D printed parts. I've had a few people contact me. My machine is down right now. I found another problem with the machine, so I gotta wait and order the part for that. But I do have some stuff printed off, so just send me an email, let me know what you're looking for, and I'll let you know if I have it. I'll certainly try to print it. The printer's about 80%. So every time I do a print, about 80% of it comes out good. The other 20% is bad. So that's kind of holding me up on quite a few things. Distributors are still available. Shop cards are available. You just got to drop me an email. Let me know you're interested in trading a shop card or you just want a shop card. I'll get that out to you. What else? That's pretty much it. You guys got any comments, suggestions for Mental Mondays? Just drop it down there in the comments. I'll ponder over it and we'll come up with something. And that's it. Not a lot to talk about. Kind of bored out of my mind, hard to get motivated on anything. You know, once you get pulled out of it and can't do nothing, it's kind of kills your mojo. Let's see. There's something else I was going to talk about, but I just left my brain. Yeah, I'm waiting on some help to get this left seat out of here. That way I can kind of scoot everything out. I can get stuff that's underneath the desk, put in stuff that's supposed to be in, and we can get that upper shelf cut down and get this piece put in. That way I can get this all repainted. We can start organizing these three build spaces anywhere. Let's get the drawers in underneath. Get the drawer in underneath here. I gotta move the light first. Get this desk extended. Get a drawer in underneath it. So yeah, we got quite a bit of stuff to do. Just can't do it yet. Well, I'm gonna call it quits here, guys. I hope you all have a nice New Year's Eve, New Year's Day. You can spend it with friends and family. We're just gonna be here. We're not doing anything. Ow. Nobody's really up to anything. This bug running around. So, I'm trying to avoid catching it myself. And with that said, I'm going to call it quits on here. We'll see you guys on Monday. Again, any comments, leave them down below. Mark, Hobby Nut Models, his link is down there. Hit it. Go pick you up a little something. Whatever it is, glue, paint, a used kit, new kit. It certainly helps this channel to bring better things to the channel to review and use and see and watch me destroy it. You know, before I get a diamond, I got to destroy it. You know, I got to tear it apart, tear into it, redo things, and then there's my diamond when it's done. So you guys tune in to watch me do that to whatever we get here. And as we do the shop, I'll take you along. Anything that comes in through the mail, we will certainly review it, go over it, and whatever other changes or ideas we have, you guys will be the first to know about it. But definitely spread the word. The faster we get to that 1,000 sub mark, the faster this giveaway happens, and then we can move on and start making plans for the next one. And we'll be hopefully assholes and elbows deep into getting the shop all rearranged and organized and starting all the new projects for next year. So, until then, guys, it's Rusty Roeder. I'm out.